Good morning all of you. In previous video we discussed about the lipid profile and the continuation of cardiac profile. In today's class we will discuss about a small one, different methods of cholesterol estimation. This is your syllabus. Here we will discuss about different methods of cholesterol estimation. So first one, so estimation of serum total cholesterol by the cholesterol oxidase peroxidase method. So principle for cholesterol oxidase peroxidase method here. So cholesterol is present as esterified with the cholesterol esters, which is present in the serum, are enzymatically hydrolyzed by the cholesterol esterase to cholesterol and free fatty acids. So then this cholesterol is oxidized by the cholesterol oxidase to cholesterol 4-ene-3-1 and hydrogen peroxidase. And the hydrogen peroxidase peroxide is combined with the 4-amino antipyrene and phenol to form the chromophore, which is quinoamine dye, which is quantity 505 nanometer. So here you can see, so cholesterol esters are hydrolyzed by the cholesterol esterase enzyme to provide cholesterol and free fatty acids. Then this cholesterol oxidized by the cholesterol oxidase enzyme to cholesterol 4-ene-3-1 and hydrogen peroxide. This hydrogen peroxide act upon by the peroxidase with 4-amino antipyrene and phenol to form the quinoamine dye, which is measured at the 505 nanometer. So this one is the enzymatic method which is regularly doing in clinical laboratories. So advantages of this enzymatic method is it is more sensitive and specific for cholesterol. Other compounds have sterile ring, do not interfere, like steroid hormones and bile acids, bile salts will not interfere with the is cholesterol estimation, and linearity up to the 700 milligrams per deciliter, and this require very low sample volume, that is less than at least 10 microliters, and less time consuming, and takes only 10 minutes of time, and require only a single non-corrosive reagent. In the next slides we will discuss about the other methods. In that we will use the corrosive reagent, it will harm our hands while doing that one, and no deprotonation is needed, and no interference by the ectric and hemolyzed serum or sera owing to the low sample volume. So these enzymatic methods are used for determination of by the auto analyzers by various diagnostic laboratories using the enzymatic kits. And the estimation of serum total cholesterol by the JAKS method. So these are manual methods which were usually doing in the practicals. So principle, in a strong acidic medium the cholesterol molecules first undergo dehydration to form the cholesterol 3,5-diene, and then oxidation and sulfonation by the concentrated sulfuric acid H2SO4 in presence of ferric ions as the catalyst to form the red color bis cholesterol 3,5-diene. So which is compared with the standard solution of cholesterol and measured at 540 nanometer or yellow green filter. So advantages of JAK method is this method is more sensitive than the Lieberman Butcher method, which we will discuss in the later slide. And color formed by the cholesterol and its esters are fairly stable for long period. And disadvantages of JAKS method, so ferric chloride and acetic acid reagent is unstable, so we have to prepare very freshly, and reagents are corrosive like H2SO4 sulfuric acid, hence they should be handled very carefully and no mouth pipetting should be done. So another method for cholesterol estimation is here Lieberman's Butcher method, which is usually qualitative method. Here is the same principle like previously discussed one. Here on treating cholesterol with here acetic anhydride and concentrated H2SO4 sulfuric acid undergo dehydration. Here also dehydration will occur and causes shift of double bond to give the 3,5-cholesterodiene to form and formation of monosulfonic acid. Here, which is a green color, which is measured at 680 nanometer or red filter with the reagent blank. And next method is Salkowski method for cholesterol measurement. This is also a qualitative method. Here you can see, so same principle like in the previous one, Lieberman Butcher method. Here also on treating cholesterol with the chloroform and concentrated sulfuric acid undergo dehydration and causes shift of double bonds to give the 3,5-cholesterodiene, which is dimerized to give bis-cholesterodiene, where in the previous one it is monocholesterodiene. Here it is double dimerized, which is undergo sulfonation to give the cholesterodiene disulfonate, which is a bluish red to purple color compound. So advantages and disadvantages are here for both. This is advantage and disadvantage both for Lieberman Butcher method and Salkowski method. So this is a simple and qualitative test for cholesterol, whereas disadvantages are it is not specific for cholesterol estimation but may also be used for the other steroid compounds which contain the sterol ring. So you know that the various compound which can be synthesized from the cholesterol within our body, bile salts, bile pigments and various steroid hormones like androgens, estrogens and glucocorticoids, all these are steroid hormones. So they may interference with this test and reagents used are corrosive, hence they are handled carefully. And also other sterols present in the small quantities may also react with the color substance like bilirubin and hemoglobin, may cause the interference. As other than that, they are the which are not regularly using, which are Carr and Drechter method and Sackett's method and also iron and salt methods. So by this we will end the cardiac profile. Okay. Thank you.